Thank y'all for 500 subs. It's crazy. Today, I thought I would switch it up for like a little special for hitting 500 subs. Again, it's a milestone and I appreciate y'all. It really, really means a lot to me. So today's video, I'm going to be explaining the history behind Nomad and who Nomad is. And now the video might be a little lengthy and I'm going to put time steps for those who do know somewhat about Nomad or at least the lore behind them. And for those who don't know about him, I would recommend watching the video for those who want to get to know about him. Now, the story begins with Little Fox. That's where it all begins, and again, I'm going to be explaining everything. Now, the story begins when Little Fox gets a call from Big Dog, and he's explaining to him that his grandfather has been missing for quite some time. He should come check things out. So Little Fox is like, okay, I'll come back to the Fox Court to see what you're talking about. Fox heads back to the court and he does more investigation and he figures out the reason why his grandfather is missing is because he is pronounced dead. Now the person connected to his death is Nomad. At first, Joey and Jason are like, you can't jump to conclusions and assume that Nomad is the reason he's dead. But again, Lil Fox is angry, filled with rage, and he just ignores them and goes on about his day. That's when he runs into Leon Carter. Now, originally, he didn't know who Carter was, and he runs into him, and Carter's like, yo, are you Little Fox? And Little Fox is like, who the heck are you? And that's when Carter's like, you should respect your elders, which I find very funny. But either way, though, he's like, I'm an old friend of Fox. And then that's when he starts respecting them. And then Little Fox is like, oh, since you're an old friend, we should get revenge on him. But Lee's confused, like, revenge? And Carter's like, just brushing off, like, don't worry about it. And then that's when Carter's like, yo, revenge is not the way. I understand you're mad, but revenge is not the way. He's, you know, being a mentor to him. And that's what he offers to be his mentor. And Lee's like, you should take this offer. Which first, Lil Fox is hesitant, but he was like, yeah. And then that's when Carter reminds him, like, Fox left his court behind for you. You should live in his legacy. Which Lil Fox, again, feels a little better about the situation. He's like, you're right. And then he just goes on about his day. Now, this is where Fee, Faye, whatever you call her, is introduced into the story. Now, originally, I viewed her as a antagonist or whatever, but I'll get to that later. She slides up on the court, and Fox is like, what you doing on my court, which again is his court. And then Fee, she's just ignoring him or whatever, and they get all hostile, and that's when she dunks the ball. You already know the story. And then she hands over a document, and it has Fox's signature on it, which is kind of confusing because he was pronounced dead. Maybe, I don't know, I'll touch on that later, but it has his signature on it. And that's when they're all lost and like, what the heck? And it has Fox's signature given over the court to Fee, aka the granddaughter of Nomad. This is where we figured out her reasoning behind coming to the court. She found some documents in her father's desk, so she came to the court to figure out what was going on. So she asked Carter, do you know who Nomad is? And he was like, how do you know Agent A? He's a big threat to the court. And the reasoning again to be coming to the court is to figure out what her father's doing, because she never really got along with her dad. And again, she found these documents, so she came to the court to figure out the truth behind these documents and what he has planned. So pretty much, as I said, first I viewed her as an antagonist, but overall she is trying to help out the situation to get everything situated out. I also think that is very interesting that she came onto the scene just to stop her dad's plan, just because they necessarily don't have the best relationship. But that's when Walker steps in. Now, his main reasoning to come into the court was to oversee Fee's safety. As you can see, when she gets into it, that's when Walker decides to step into the scene and just get in the way of everything, I guess you could say. I don't know, but that's when he decides to step in. Now, originally, again, like I said, his first reasoning or his main reasoning to come into the court is to make sure Fee safe, because that's his main objective. At least those were the orders that were given to him by Nomad. And this is where the story again starts to get a little more interesting or starts to change. Now, originally, his main objective was to oversee Faye's safety. But as time progresses, he also goes with this other plan, which is to take over the Fox Court. Now, I thought I would add this inside the video just because this is the first time you really get a little glimpse of Nadia before she's really introduced into the game. Even though the Big Flo doesn't really have a connection to Nomad whatsoever, I still thought I'd add this just because 3-on-3 likes to tease their characters and then introduce them into the game a little bit later. You know how I said Fee was originally the antagonist of the story, or that's what I presumed her to be her ass, because how she came aggressive at Fox and the others? Well, this is where Fee's actually portrayed as a protagonist, at least in my eyes, because she decides to call Nadia because she's a lawyer, and she tells Nadia, I want you to figure out what's going on with the whole Fox situation, and not only that, I want to figure out what my dad is doing behind the scenes and why he wants this court. After Nadia finds out more information on the Fox case, she goes addresses Little Fox and tells him everything that has been happening behind the scenes. So they're in a room and they're discussing everything, and Little Fox gets upset and he runs out the room, and then that's when he runs into Walker and runs into Deacon. Now, well, this is where Walker says that the boss commanded Deacon to be brought to the court just so they could take over the court. Now, for those who don't know, again, Walker's boss is Nomad, and this is again where the situation starts to get all over the place, at least in my perspective, because originally it says that Fee's father was Nomad, but now that's his granddaughter. I don't know what they're doing with the whole story at this point. But either way, I believe he was brought to the court just to, again, be a menace, keep Lil Fox and his friends off the court, and nobody can really keep up in check, especially since bro knows MMA. I'm pretty sure not too many people really want to mess with Deacon. This is where I think Fee develops more as a protagonist in the story, because she calls Jack. And again, for those who don't know, Jack also knows MMA, which is not really important to the story, but I believe she called him, or he was brought to the court so he could keep Deacon in check, at least until they get the whole Fox situation under control. Mila doesn't really have any type of connection towards Nomad whatsoever. I mean, she has a little connection towards Faye, but again, it's not really significant in any way, at least towards the story whatsoever. Now, she has a connection towards Noah, and Noah has a connection towards Fox, I guess. She has a connection towards Fox, but I thought I'd throw this in here because this is the first time we get to see Noah teased. And for those who don't know, 3-on-3 likes to tease future characters in the videos, and I thought this was a very significant teaser, so I was like, let me just throw it in this video for those who didn't recognize it. Now, this is where Noah is introduced, and like Camila, Noah doesn't really have a connection towards Nomad whatsoever, but he does have a connection towards Fox. So again, this is where they decided to pick back up on the story, because again, with Camila, that's where they just left the story out for a quick second. At least they didn't add too much detail to it, at least from my perspective again. But this is where Noah is introduced. Now, Fee was doing some work behind the scenes with Noah, and Noah does find some information, and he does give documents towards V, which is an important part in the story. I didn't include Ayla's part of the story because I don't want the video to be too lengthy, but pretty much Ayla came to the court to revenge on her sister, and now they're just, I don't know, they're fighting. It's all messy, and she separated the members. So Lil Fox came to the court looking for a place to play basketball, and this is where Fox actually makes his appearance. Now, what I find amazing and kind of funny is that Big Dog looked at Fox like, what did you say when he said grandpa? And Big Dog was the one calling him, telling him that your grandfather has been missing for quite some time. So I was like, how does bro not know who Fox is? But yeah, you the one who told him that his grandfather has been missing for quite some time. Either way, this is where the story picks up again, and this is where Fox decides to make his appearance and get everything situated out. Now, as Fox says here, he originally was never supposed to come back, but with Fee's persistence and she just kept trying, he does end up coming back. Now, I really don't understand why him and Nomad had a falling out. I do understand that they were close with each other and they're very good friends, but again, they had a falling out, and with this, Nomad threatened to take the court away from Fox, and Fox just disappeared. At least that's the short summary of what happened. So Fox just went into hiding, and then that's when Nomad went full on with his plan. And again, Fee was the protagonist in our story, as I keep saying. She wanted to stop her father slash grandfather, whatever he is to her, wanted to stop his plans too. So that's again where she decided to bring Fox back, and not only that, help Fox regain his court. With Fox making his return to the court, he knew he's going to face his problem sooner or later. So this is where he decides to finally face his fears and finally decides to face his old student, Double D. Double D was Fox's greatest student in his youth and in his past, and nobody doubted his future, but tragically he was diagnosed with a heart disease, and this is when Fox decided to leave, and he just left him. And that's when slowly but surely everybody was forgetting who Double D was, and he had no hope for his future. But one day somebody suggested go to the chairman so he can get a reinforced heart, which he did, and after that he started training really hard to get revenge, and after that he became Nomad's very greatest apprentice. Now, I was trying to get more information on the whole situation, trying to figure out why exactly they left Double D, because I kind of did think that was messed up. How you abandon somebody after you figure out they were diagnosed with a heart disease? So I was like, know it. Let me see from his perspective and also Fox's perspective. Let me not be biased and let me sympathize for both of them. I know that's kind of weird, especially off of a 3-on-3 story. But either way, I was trying to get details. So I was reading, and then Carter, when he talks to Carter, which I found very interesting, is that the reason they left him, of course, was the heart disease, but they didn't want him to push himself too hard because he kept pushing himself more than he had to, and he was like, you would have lost your life. But then that's when he was like, it's deeper than that. How you guys just abandoned me like that? You guys are the only people I had, which I kind of felt, even though I don't relate in any type of way, I kind of felt that. And then after that, that's when he addresses V too, because we all know that Double D messes with the chairman, aka Nomad, very, very heavy, especially after bringing him up when they just abandoned him like that. So he dresses Fee, and he's like, I don't know what you've been doing behind the scenes. You better not mess with the chairman, because I'll take you down. I also know your weakness. He just goes on. And then he said, with this tournament up, don't do anything. And I was like, interesting. They're having a tournament now. So I wonder if they're going to add a court for when Nomad comes out. I don't know. But I feel like they just keep adding little bits and bits. So as of right now, he's the main antagonist until Nomad drops, which I believe Nomad will be the next character, which I'll talk about in a couple seconds. Now, we see it with Nadia, we see it with Fox, and we also see it with Nomad as he steps out the helicopter. 3on3 likes to tease their future characters, and I do believe he'll be a future character, especially with the way that video ended and all the events leading up to Nomad. I think it's about time they finally release him, especially with him being a big part in 3on3's lore. I think it'll be very interesting, and also think he'll be a small forward. Now, don't quote me on it, but I do like to see what they do with him. Now, this is where I end the video again. Thank y'all for those who stayed throughout the whole video, and thank y'all for those who even watched it again. The video was kind of lengthy, but this is just the video describing who Nomad is. Again, I appreciate y'all, and thank y'all for 500 subs. Please sub to the channel and leave a like.